Hello, hello, and welcome to my review of the second episode of Adventure Time, Trouble in Lumpy Space. Now, for a brief summary, Jake gets bit accidentally by Lumpy Space Princess, which turns him lumpy. In order to save him, they have to go to Lumpy Space and get the antidote before sunset. Finn manages to save Jake by lumpifying himself, and they barely get out smooth. This episode is a whole lot better than the last episode, in my opinion. And I actually think they should have switched Slumber Party Panic and Trouble in Lumpy Space around, and let off with this episode, because it is stronger. And the primary reason for that is because there's humor scattered throughout, and there's lots of funny one-liners, lots of funny dialogue, many memorable quotes to take away.
Whatever, it's 2009! Lump off, Mom! I'll kill you, Lumpy Space!
We dig your directionless fury.
This episode, of course, introduces us to Lumpy Space Princess, LSP, for the first time. This is a character I've heard people say they get tired of with overexposure. When there's too much of her, people say they kind of get tired of her gimmick, and it kind of grows boring. I can see the argument there, but I think she's used sparingly enough, and with enough episodes kind of in between her main appearances, that she still stays very funny and very amusing. Particularly because there's a lot of dialogue revolving around her that's just hilarious, and a lot of situations she creates that are very amusing. So I am a big fan of Lumpy Space Princess. Another thing I noticed going back through the series is that Finn has a lot of facial expressions that are quite different from the later episodes. I actually think that's awesome. They really varied how they animate his facial expressions, which themselves are already very distinct. Adventure Time has a simplistic art style, but that by no means limits the creativity and what sorts of faces Finn or Jake can contort and create. And it's awesome that they actually animated certain faces that they don't use in later episodes. They create new ones instead. This episode also introduces us to portals. I don't quite remember offhand how many other portals there have been in Adventure Time, but not really many. Seeing as how this is the second episode, I actually kind of assumed back when I first watched it that there was going to be a lot of portals hidden all over the Land of U, and that the Land of U would kind of be like a central hub world, and then there'd be lots of portals to other, you know, dimensions or worlds or part of the planet where you could travel, sort of like a video game. But that's not the direction they took it in. There's nothing wrong with that, it's just sort of the impression I got at the time. And it's actually kind of nicer that I think they kept the Land of U more compact and stuck to the physical location more. I think it creates a lot more mysteries, therefore, when we see actual portals and other dimensions, or somehow we, you know, get transported into outer space or whatnot. I think that leaves kind of a bit more wonder and a bit more mystery about the series. So I actually think it's a good move to kind of limit the amount of portals. Keeps the world a bit more grounded. And of course, Lumpy Space. I assume it's actually in space, but they do call the space below Lumpy Space, you know, the Endless Abyss. So perhaps it is in another dimension? I have read that Pendleton Ward has said that LSP was made from irradiated stardust, I believe. So that further supports that Lumpy Space is actually in space, you know, somewhere above Earth, or who knows, maybe even farther away. Either way, Lumpy Space, drama, all about drama, it's a world of drama. I'm not even sure if kids can relate to it, like, you know, young viewers who haven't made it to junior high yet, where I think the drama kind of starts up. It's funny nonetheless, it's super hilarious. Whether kids get it or not, I don't know, but it was a good move on their part, because really all ages I think can enjoy it, even if the kids don't understand it. I found the smooth posers actually really interesting. When LSP first calls them that, I was expecting them to be sort of be druggies, because they're also abusing the antidote ball by sitting on it and becoming smooth, and sort of seems, you know, like they're kind of getting, like, high off it. But then at the same time, they have elements of, like, kind of nerds, and also kind of elements of rebels to them, or, like, punks. So it seems like they're sort of just an amalgam of people kind of ostracized or outcasted by society, or people who feel disenfranchised from the society they're in. They kind of just, like, meshed all these things together. If you look at their faces, they seem to have, like, what's the equivalent of acne, but they also kind of wear clothes and have facial hair that implies a sort of hipster-type edge to them. I don't know, I felt instead of going for, like, one archetype, it was cool that they kind of just mixed a whole bunch of outsider archetypes together. So, I think they're very effective. And they have them using dialogue, of course. And it's actually kind of interesting, because they seem like pretty nice guys. When Finn needs to save Jake, and talks about lumpifying himself and jumping the gap across the clouds, they seem to genuinely care about him and his safety. And they kind of, you know, say, no, don't do this, because they think he's gonna kill himself. So, I thought it was cool that they actually made him really caring characters. I didn't sort of expect that. I guess it makes sense when everybody else in Lumpy Space is sort of like this self-absorbed, you know, douchebag. It makes sense that I guess the people who are rebelling against that kind of society would be sort of nice and caring. And then this episode has some interesting things about Lumpy Space Princess herself. So she's called Lumpy Space Princess, but if we look at her house, you know, the first thing I noticed is, yeah, it's a fairly big house, I think it's like 2 or 3 stories, but it doesn't really look like a castle, it doesn't look like a kingdom, it doesn't look like actual royalty. And even though her parents say the royal car, I wasn't really convinced that LSP was actual royalty. I thought maybe, like, she's named Lumpy Space Princess just because that's part of her name. There's a doctor princess in the series, and princess part is just her surname. I thought maybe it's a situation like that. This is further supported by the episode at the end of season 4 when Finn and Jake collect all the jewels from the princesses for the Ankyridian. They collect LSP's star, and it doesn't fit into the Ankyridian at all. They kind of end up just tossing it aside. Then also, her jewel makes her float. When she dimmed her star on her head in the beginning of the episode, she couldn't float anymore. And her parents have the stars as well. By the way, her parents are fused together, which I thought was kind of hilarious, and was wondering how that would even happen, because everybody else in Lumpy Space, you know, are distinct people. Maybe getting married in Lumpy Space has you fused together. That'd be horrible. But anyway, my main point is she has a star that allows her to float, but all the other Lumpy people, they seem to float on their own without any sort of jewel, and Finn turns into a Lumpy person, and he floats just fine. In fact, he turned into a Lumpy person so he could float across the gap. So it's kind of weird that she needs to, you know, use the power of her jewel to float. I'm not sure if that's a continuity error or if that's some other aspect that hasn't really been explored in regards to LSP. So just little interesting details I noticed. So while LSP comes across as really self-absorbed, she does seem to want to help her friends, and she does seem to kind of care for others, but that care is quickly overwritten by her own desires. But I really enjoyed how they gave her some self-awareness. She says, "Not like the fake friends I have here," or something along those lines. So she realizes in her tantrum that the people around her in Lumpy Space aren't really her true friends. They're just kind of superficial friends due to circumstance, and they're all kind of trying to fit into this society that's been constructed, and it's not aligned for genuine friendship, and Lumpy Space Princess is aware enough to realize that, but that fake sense of belonging is enough to make her feel at least somewhat happy, and she does get invested in this kind of superficial drama. So, she's a bit of an interesting character, actually. She feels kind of empty and vacuous, but there's definitely room to explore her character, and they do it much later in the series. It's actually a bit tragic, but I won't be talking about that for a very long time. So, to summarize this episode, it, you know, not much depth to it, kind of typical cartoon fare, but lots of good humor, lots of potential development for later, kind of brought up. I didn't dislike it. I liked it a bit. I didn't love it, but it was a fun episode, and therefore, I don't really have too much to say about it because of that. I will end my review here, and see you guys next time.